coming from Asia. And it is my mistake because this day I didn't speak. I show only that we have to speak also about transfer from defense to attack and from attack to defense, but I did not show this schema. In reality, you will start attack from the beginning to the end only with one player. Goalkeeper receives the ball and goalkeeper shoot on the opposite goal. And attack is finished. Can be goal or can be mistake. Or you are in defense, you are catching the pass from opponent and you are going the dribbling alone. From the start of attack till the end of attack is involved only one player, one attacker. Goalkeeper or player. We say counter-attack in this moment. Yeah? Here is defense. Return defense. Defense which already return, but is not full organized. And here is already defense, which was ready to take correct formation and disorganize. This one is time. This one is time. And this one, how many players are involved in this attack? Can be only one, can be group with goalkeeper or without goalkeeper, can be team. With goalkeeper or without goalkeeper. And according to this situation, we make difference between counter-attack, only one person, first wave, it is mostly somebody who is in defense in forwards position and sometimes six is fierce, very easy or basic situation is goalkeeper receive ball and give long pass for somebody who is coming in attack. What is problem? I was teaching. But if you are looking top matches, this easy fast break is not anymore so often. It's necessary that is involved also second wave. Also, the rest of player is coming. Sometimes, in theory, for example, Spain, they are speaking about first, second, and third wave. Two, and two. Some also pyramid. First wave is very bright, and last are these people which are doing, but mostly we have first and second wave, and if it's not possible to finish and defenders are already back, very often you can see by the teams that they, without any long preparation combination, immediately are coming to short combination and to the shot. Typically is also after, if you receive the goal, is fast through off. Or because opponent was coming already back, but is not organized don't expect that will be directly this finalization of attack. And if it's this one not successful, then call in the question build up attack, position attack. Little bit more preparation, etc. Also, this structure of coming from defense to attack, sometimes from different reasons, you are not going in fast break, you are not going in prolongation, you are starting only build up. But of course, more effective is if it is possible to use this fast break. As always, as we told you by this day, all these exercises are only examples because we can use thousands of different exercises. It is only for inspiration, and always we are trying to show a little bit some methodical order, from very easy to more and more complicated. You have to take inspiration, but please, each exercise, each methodical order, you have to adapt of your specific situation. We taught it already first day. Each player is different. Each team is different. And firstly, you must know what you would like to achieve. What is your goal? What you would like to have by you are doing these exercises. And each exercise is possible to adapt. Each exercise is possible to do in very different variant. And you are responsible for it. Nobody will do it for you. If somebody will come to me and ask, give me a plan for my team, I will say never, I will never do it. Because I don't know your situation, firstly. And secondly, plan is something what is construction. But also, like in life and like in the game, you have some plan and you see that from different reasons this plan is not running or opposite, that is running too good. And in this moment you have to change a little bit. You have to go step back or you can go faster step forwards. I was only 4 years professional coach in Belgium. And I have time always to make preparation. But always after training against, I was writing what was really possible to do and what was problem. Because it's necessary to react of concrete situation. You understand? Yes.
Yeah?
And I have experience before. I was also coach in Czechia, but I was also a teacher, and sometimes I didn't have time to be prepared. And always, if I was not prepared, it was not good. Because then you are using routine, and you are not anymore creative. Only people which are prepared can be creative. It is my experience. something about this individual and group training and team training. We spoke with Dietrich a lot about this. And he will also speak about, but I would like to speak about two experiences. One is from Czechia in the past, because was coming this regulation from no government, because in Czechia it's not Ministry for Sport, it's only, was only sport board. It was not government, it was, but they have relatively big power in this time before political changes, and they thought that must be more training and more training. Look what is doing Russia, look what is doing East German, for example. More and more, but it is not possible to have always more and more. And if you have too much, then you are losing intensity. And intensity, explosivity is so important for handball. It's not necessary to be in 100% tempo in during the all the match. You must be able to find best situation to exploit. One-to-one situation, shooting, go through, that is important. In correct moment to do it faster as opponent or bring the opponent to the mistake and to do it easy for my teammate. Also, it's necessary to find balance. Sometimes too much is not the best, if you understand. And I spoke it this second, and this time we spoke about it with my colleague in university, and we was meaning that it was, I don't think that is correct, but in this time was meaning that three team training per week is enough, but the rest must be group and individual preparation. And second experience, it is from Mats Olsson, because Mats Olsson was first time with team of Norway, ladies, Olympic winner in Beijing. First time by this Olympic preparation, and he thought that during Olympic Games, they did not have team training. They have only individual and group training during 3 weeks. They was together only for tactical preparation because they have enough team preparation before, and they would also like to avoid to be too much together. Yeah? And for me, it's not possible to tell that is best or not 100% best solution, but think a little bit about it. Yeah? I remember what was Russia doing, Soviet Union in the past, but it was possible maybe only in Soviet Union. They have long time preparation. They was 3 weeks, 4 weeks together. And each week they change who will be sleeping together. Also, you was sleeping first week together, second week no, you have to change. It's forbidden if you was on the same place, was forbidden to go together for walking, and was forbidden to go together for the eating. Yeah? Always change to avoid this underwater fruit. I don't know how to tell it. Underwater ship, and people are always together, and then is coming conflict. Maybe you know it also from family sometimes, yeah? If you are too much together. Also, sorry, I was speaking too much. And if you have a question, please, now you can give a question. No question for this board. Everything is clear.
You know this. Yeah. Also, is that? Yeah. You know exercise, can we make it for the, it's not for talking, for presenting, and the number of the court and presenting their opinion.
Yeah, yeah, only that you explain a little bit, explain a little bit what is the main focus in this topic, what the idea for methodical steps, and maybe also the tactical aspect behind it. Yeah, how you want to act in a defense against the block or screening. Yeah, how you want to do this. Maybe you can explain, can do differences. And you can explain, okay, we want to focus to this behavior. You understand?
Morning, what we thought, it was only an example. We, of course, we will not look stopwatch. We will not look it. But generally, you have 15 minutes. Yes. And if you have four exercises and some explanation, it is 3 minutes plus minus from each. Yeah? Also, in 3 minutes, you must be able to organize it with this team and to start these exercises. It is different, like by our work. It is not typical training lesson. It is lesson with one selected topic, focus only on one topic. If it will be training lesson, it will be completely different. Yeah.
You explained about the criteria for winger and pivot.
For what?
For winger and pivot player. For winger and pivot player, the ball must be all the time. And then for the pivot, for the winger, the knee always strike. But must be avoided for backcourt. What's the criteria for shooting for the backcourt? What's criteria for the backcourt shooting? The basic skill for shooting, for backcourt player.
Yeah, we have different technical development, so this is important to know. Okay, until now, when you have a jump shot, a lot of players have this backswing, that is clear, but you see Hansen is the best model, he's doing this, but we have also a different trend in a straight shot. Yes, this movement. And it is like, I will show you like this. We made a very different analysis about this with high-speed camera, with much more pictures. And in a second, then you can see this movement. He's doing like this, looking here, also here, not here. That is also an idea. And he's going with the elbow here, and then with this, is a short, only a short swing. That is throwing this. It's interesting movement. Look to this player. So also some bench they are doing this thing. It's like this. Not this. Like this. Oh, here. And it's like, what is the English word for peitsche? What is this here? Some individual specifications or technical trends, but the idea behind is reduce the time. Reduce the time, not. Okay, in training with children, you have to to teach those guys when you start. Yeah? But the trend is to reduce, to be more quicker. So that was the reason that I think that will be continuing in the next years, that the technical repertoire changes a little bit. That is clear.
In the 70s, they were going from down.
Yeah.
The whole loop.
Therefore, it's only also an information to you. Don't look every time to the tactics or what they are doing now. Look also to individual behaviors. look a little bit how they are shooting.
Genetics.
Or what they are doing in the defense. How they are doing the body contact or how they are acting.
I can't make commitments.
Yeah. Look a little bit, it's interesting. The things to know. Yeah.
It is similar. I was telling you that I was given it already on this USB disk. Sorhendo, Miro from Norway, and Agri Nagalde from Spain. Three very good people, but everybody is different.
Yeah.
Everybody different behavior. Also, rookie also. It's not always necessary to have 120 kilo like the people from
yes.
Hungary, for example, or from Macedonia.
Yeah, it depends also what is the question of philosophy. You must decide for yourself. But we said it in Germany, it is a must that people have to act in the defense, not to change. And then you must be a little bit flexible also in the footwork. That is clear. Yeah, the movements. I need also some movements. I don't like that. But that's okay. We had a lot of problems with him, the referees, and with the rules, interpretation. A lot of in the past, maybe in the last years, was a little bit better. But a lot of actions from him was against the rule. It was clear for us attacker. So that is okay, you can act here, but not every time. Yeah. But it's also a question. You have to look a little bit more to rule interpretations. You have to teach this also. It's also a big question in individual training. For defense and also for pivots or whatever. It's also important. At the end,
Because they are mostly afraid. And if you tell, take protection, they are more sure. They did not close their eyes. Yeah? And it is really protection. You can see and you are protecting the face. It is recommendation. It's not necessary to accept it, but to think about it.
And if you look to this team, which I was working with this team on yesterday and today, and you look a little bit to the performance of all positions, backcourt, pivot, and wing, okay, it was different also between the players, okay, you can find some talents, this is also clear, but when I'm compared with, let me say, the European level, then they are really behind. Really behind. Really behind. Maybe I said it to Fertyshek at the end of basic training, beginning of advanced training. They are really behind. Think about what is the reason. I'm always a little bit shocked when I receive the information that they have so much training sessions. Then my next question is what they are doing. Okay. It's not a hard information, think about this a little bit. use the time, think about your training structure. In China, we know now a little bit more. I know the results of the analysis of each women national player, which make in Germany now. Looks not so nice. They make a lot of tests. Also, the doctor was looking, and not so good information. This is the question: what was happened in the chain? You will receive more information in detail. But I think it was a good way to do this. It was a totally analysis with tests, with physical situation. A lot of players have a lot of injuries. So, also the question, what happened in the chain? So, that is also one big topic in the next course, and we'll discuss it. We'll invite experts.
And it is not only China. In Czechoslovakia, ladies, 1985, was second in the world championship and directly qualified for Olympic Games in Korea. And they have 2 years, they was full professional. And they was doing a lot. And after Olympic Games, one knee, another knee, and I take over this team, and we made in my university research, and from 24 players, only 2 was okay. 24 players disbalances. This mean some muscle too overloaded and some muscle not enough. It was not in balance. And if you are muscle not in balance, for how is English? Not, but special by ladies, knee. Yeah? Big problem.
So there is that's a big topic in the second course. That's a big topic. We made a good experience in such courses. We invite really specialists for this. And you have to work with specialists in this case. You can't do it alone. You need really good specialists. Athletic specialists.
For example, after this experience, my students from physiotherapy make for each player individual program. But what do you think? In this time, they was professional concerning time, but not professional with thinking. They was doing it by common meeting, but then they was going to the club and they was not doing it anymore. Now players are more clever. Now they understand that they are leaving professional player from handball and that they would like to prolong career for longer time.
In Germany, we are doing this long years now. All national players, starting from the youth, received the whole year individual programs, specific for their needs. One player needs this, another player needs this, and every 2-3 months, we control, check, and so on. That is running besides it. They can do it at home. We have nice methods now for this. They receive exercises and whatever. And the most of the teams are doing
it. One of protagonists of this individual task and individual preparation was Vladoš Tencel, because he was given to each player What it's necessary to do if it's not together with the national team. And players was responsible for it. They won. If you are motivated, you are okay, it's time to go to eat.